You know what? Let's run through a quick history of ancient mining, right? Why not? It's something I've always wanted to talk about, and there's no time like the present. Don't forget to ring the bell so YouTube will send you a notification about all of our videos. But to the mines, let's begin.
Be on your guard. There are older and fouler things than orcs in the deep places of the world.
Far back in time, as in beginning of 2001, a space odyssey back, Homo sapiens started to use rocks as weapons, as well as tools to dig for other minerals they could use for cutting and use as more advanced tools and weapons. We're talking almost 2 million years ago. When Homo sapiens began to form communities, they started trading with one another. That included the minerals found in different regions. Don't think gold and silver either, think chert and obsidian. Both of these minerals were handy for their sharp edges. Chert is a sedimentary rock that forms in nodules of limestone, and obsidian is an igneous rock formed above the Earth's surface when molten rock is rapidly cooled. Remember how I said early humans traded minerals found in different regions of the world? Obsidian is a perfect example. Its range is limited to areas with volcanic activity. All this trade means communicating with other tribes of people, just as important to the basis of civilization as agriculture. One of the most ancient mines we know about is roughly 43,000 years old and is found in Swaziland, Africa. The people who worked there used stone tools made from the igneous rock dolerite. They mined hematite and specularite, both of which are types of iron ore. We have a video on hematite you can watch here. It was often used for its red pigment, but what they really wanted was the specularite. Specularite has no surface oxidation, so it somewhat resembles glitter. They would break the minerals down into a mixture that was smeared on the bodies of chiefs and priests. So this 43,000-year-old mine was for what exactly? Cosmetics. 10 to 7,000 years ago was when mining became a major industry for certain communities. In Neolithic France and Britain, chalk mine shafts had been found. What, were there a lot of chalkboards in the Neolithic? Nope, but flint is a kind of chert formed in chalk, and flint sometimes has a pretty sharp edge when broken. Broken sharp edge? That's a knife or an arrowhead. Around 4 to 3000 BCE, Egyptians began mining the Sinai Peninsula for copper, which they used for tools, weapons, and ornaments. They also excavated malachite and azurite in those early mines. They tried to place the mines next to rivers, using the waters as the first ancient highways to transport the goods to their final destination. They actually smelted the copper on site. They took the ore and broke it into smaller pieces and mixed it with charcoal in in-ground pits. The amount of heat would allow the metal to separate from the rock without becoming molten. Remove the fuel, cool it down, and then collect the copper. Eventually, furnaces came along, which allowed people to heat the metal enough to make it molten, which they could shape into ingots. Way easier to transport, by the way. The Bronze Age begat the Iron Age, and as more communities of people settled around the Mediterranean Sea, mining became a huge ancient industry. The Laurian mines in Athens, for instance, made the city rich from silver. Part of the reason the Roman Empire was so vast was that they kept conquering places for mines. That's exactly why they went to Britain, and you can learn a little bit more about it in our video on the Roman Empire. After the fall of the Roman Empire and throughout Europe in the early Middle Ages, most mines were worked by individuals who paid a tax to the government / warlord for the right to work the land. Interested in more videos on the history of mining? Let us know in the comments. You know the drill, get it? Like, subscribe, check out the links for more information, and of course, thanks for watching.